Hello, Linda.
Hello, everybody. How are you?
Very well. It's nice to have you on board today. Are you ready for your session?
Yes, I'm ready. I think so.
Thank you very much. Please, can you just introduce yourself and what you'll be speaking to us about today?
My name is Linda Vosjan. I was born in Amsterdam, the Netherlands, and raised on the island of Texel. In the north of the Netherlands, where I am at this moment, visiting my mother. I'm in the study of my father, who deceased 4 years ago and who was actually of great influence and inspiration to me during his life because he was a scientist and working on all kinds of ecosystem subjects. And for me, actually, I became a teacher of French and English. That's my education. So I've been in secondary schools teaching French, not for a very long time because I became a journalist afterwards. I got fed up with all the bad news being a journalist. At one point, I understood that if storytellers always, like journalists, tell the always are always telling the negative stories that people start to believe those negative stories and they think that we're living in a bad world. Actually, most of things are actually going right, but we're always highlighting the things that are going wrong. And therefore, I decided to stop working for in the mainstream media and covering the mainstream news. And I became a journalist in cultural news, so interviewing all kinds of artists and performers. Maybe I've got a little bit of a bad connection, but hopefully I'm back to completely dedicate my life to regeneration of the world and to start with my own neighborhood. That's in Amsterdam, Eiburg, a brand new neighborhood. And yeah, and I've to work in the whole city of Amsterdam, to work in the whole of the Netherlands. And now at Climate Clean, we're working internationally. Yeah, so that's a bit about me. I'm 52 years old. I've got two beautiful daughters who regenerative planet for the future and a healthy food system, which we don't have at this moment. And yeah, and I encourage all youth and everybody to join the regeneration. It's all about doing. So you read a bit, you talk a bit, and then you make plans and you start doing, and not like we in Western society, we're so used to just talking, and then we think the world is going to change. No, it's not going to change by just talking. You also have to start doing, and that's what I would like to present you my presentation about some knowledge and how you can start acting yourself.
Thank you very much. Just before you go into your presentation, I would like to know how your work in climate came into play because you didn't make mention of that. How did you get into the sector from journalism to advocating for sustainable practices to prevent climate change from having adverse effects?
Could you rephrase your question because I don't totally get it, what you would like me to answer?
I said, like, while you were introducing yourself, you didn't tell us about how you started climate cleanup. But would like to know a little bit about that.
Oh yeah. Actually, I'm not a founder. That's Sven Jensen, but I joined him in an early stage because I was working with Sven. He's also living in Amsterdam, and Sven and I were working on renewable energy. And a couple of years ago, because we thought in the beginning it was all about renewable energy, what's said about burning fossil fuels, that was the big enemy. Of course it is. We have to stop burning fossil fuels, but that's not all, as I'm going to explain later. And Sven highlighted that to me. He said, Linda, you know, renewable energy is already cheaper than fossil fuels a couple of years ago already, like solar panels, wind turbines. And so he said, Sven said to me, the market will do its work. People will buy solar panels because it's cheaper. So the system is going to change by itself. But for the rest, there's so much to do what is not going to change yet. And we have to start working on those subjects. And those subjects are not are about removing CO2 from the atmosphere. Practically no one is working on that explicitly. And we already know for a very long time that there's too much CO2 in the air already at this moment. And we are emitting every day more and more. So we have to stop emissions and we have to clean up. That's where the name comes from, climate cleanup. We have to clean up this excess of CO2, which is in the air, which is in the ocean, by nature. That's our vision. We have to put the CO2 where it came from, and that's nature. And that's how climate cleanup emerged from that idea. And our change theory is that the people who are actually going to do that are entrepreneurial people and entrepreneurs. So we see this distinction. Not everybody is an entrepreneur, but in all professions, there are entrepreneurial people, people who know they have to act. So they put up their sleeves and they start doing and they start helping other people. So it's about joining, helping. Let your hands, your head, and your heart work together. And the good news is the flow will happen if you start doing that. You will enter a certain flow. That's my experience. And you also start. I used to be really angry as a journalist. You're also all the time you're angry, because you're just interviewing everybody who's not acting in the right way. So you're like, okay, this is my microphone. Okay, so that's, you made a quite a mess of that situation, politician Mr. John. No, I did not make a mess of it. I think not. La 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 la. And the thing is about changing that conversation as well into what humanity and the world needs now. And of course, you also have to control power, and we need, of course, to interview also in that way. But we have a lack of telling what we actually want. What do we want? We're always talking about what we don't want, but what do we want, and how can we get there? And that's what my story is about, and that's what climate cleanup is about.
Well, that's very brilliant, and you've made a very fair point there, because you're actually very right. We talk about what we do not want, but rarely talk about what we want. And I hope, I hope we can actually start to do this, speak more about what we want and less about what we don't want from now henceforth. Thank you.
Yeah.
You've got the floor. You can go on with your presentation now.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Richard.
Yeah.
I'll take a look where it is. Yes, it's here. share. So here it is. Present. So, hello, everybody around the world. Regenerative people. It's the 16th of October, 2021. And my name is Linda Vosjo. You see my email address, linda@climatecleanup.org. I work at climatecleanup.org, Climate Cleanup. Also for Drawdown Europe. I'm going to explain you later about Drawdown. And my local organization in my own neighborhood, Amsterdam, Eiburg, is natuurlijkeiburg.nl. So if you would like to take a look at all those organizations where we actually do, then please take a look. And if you would like to email me, linda@climatecleanup.org. Looking forward to all your emails, because we have to connect. The name of my presentation is Power to the Burgers, and that's a bit of a joke, because the Dutch word burger also means a hamburger, vegetarian one, or the old-fashioned meat one, but it also means citizens. In Dutch, burger means citizen, and actually I think as citizens we have to stand up. So it's power to the citizens, and of course it's power to plants-based diet, where we can eat still a little bit of meat, but not as much as we do now. Okay, we are the mycelium. I don't know if you've heard about the mycelium. It's actually fungus, paddenstoelen, schimmel in Dutch. You see here, how big a mushroom can get. It's incredible. Actually, the mushroom is the flower of what's happening in the soil, and what's happening in the soil with the bacteria, the water, the roots of the trees and other plants. That's what we call the mycelium. And this is the mycelium. We can't see it, but it's all around us. It's all around, everywhere where you are. It's connected much more as we know. The scientists know more and more about it and are surprised about how much is going on beneath our feet. And this, of course, is how it could look like also if you see it popping up. And actually a lot of mushrooms are, you can eat them, and they're very healthy. And there are also people talking about the spiritual help the mycelium could give us to people. So it helps you, they can help you see more connections around you. That's not my, I'm not an expert on that, so I'm not going to elaborate on that, but you can find a lot on the internet. For example, you can watch the Netflix. It's on Netflix. It's fantastic fungi. It's a fantastic documentary. Take a look at it. Fantastic fungi. So we are the mycelium. Why are we as people also the mycelium? Because we are connecting, like Richard is and Xander, everyone who's been organizing this day, they are connecting us now. So I'm connecting from Texel in the north of the Netherlands, this little island, to the rest of you all around the world, and we're connected already. You have to feel it, and you have to just feel it and feel the connection. We are connected. We are the mycelium, like the fungus and the viruses and the bacteria and the roots beneath our feet. We as people are the mycelium too. This is a book that has just been published I've got it here. I don't know if you if you can see me too, but it's been published a month ago. And Paul Hawken is of great inspiration to me and everybody at Climate Cleanup, because he finds the words that we need. And I didn't read the book entirely yet, but some pieces of it, and it's even better than the book he has been publishing before, and that's Drawdown. I'm going to talk about Drawdown in a minute. And if you haven't heard of Drawdown, please do Google it. Drawdown, Project Drawdown. It's a great project. It's about all the climate solutions we need. It's about regenerating the planet. It's about the whole system that is we have to change, and that's already happening right now. So this regeneration book, Ending the Climate Crisis in One Generation, Climate Cleanup is going to translate it in Dutch, but that will take a couple of months. And if you, I will really buy the book. And you need to really to read it, because we have to end the climate crisis in one generation. Do you agree? Do you agree? I think you do. And food is a very, very important part of it. I will explain. What did I read in this book? I made a picture of it. If we go to the left side, today's food system has become the single greatest cause of global warming, soil loss, chemical poisoning, chronic disease, rainforest destruction, and dying oceans. That's what Paul Hawken writes in this book at page 171. So take a moment for yourself to realize that today's food system has become the single greatest cause of global warming, soil loss, so that means degraded land, you know, dry lands with no nature on it, chemical poisoning, you know what that is, chronic disease, you know what that is, rainforest destruction, unfortunately, you know what that is as well, and dying oceans, that means less and less animals in the oceans, less and less plants, and acidification of the oceans because of CO2. It makes it really sour, the oceans. And I made a picture of what he wrote, and actually I would like to read it to you. I used to be a teacher, so I would like to read out loud. So, now and then, I hope you will forgive me that. But I think it's great what Paul Hawken has been writing here. He says, most of the world no longer needs to seek food, as for 200 million years, people were always looking for food, but nowadays, most of the world no longer needs to seek food. It comes to us in an extraordinarily complex and sophisticated system that has created unparalleled abundance. There's abundance, that's a very important word as well. However, today's food system has become the single greatest cause of global warming, soil loss, chemical poisoning, chronic disease, rainforest destruction, and dying oceans. Because people love to eat and taste, the food system, for all its myriad ills and assaults, offers an extraordinary opportunity to regenerate soil. Hey, to regenerate soil, climate, community, cultures, and human health. It's the keystone solution because it either upholds or degrades every aspect of human endeavor, and impact addresses here forests, farms, soil, oceans, cities, water, industry, and energy. The key to regenerating our food system is, and this is really nice, taste. Your taste. How does something taste? It sounds absurd, perhaps, but due to commercially produced processed foods, we may have lost our taste and we may need to regain it. And Yeah, I really like this part of his book. You know, I think I didn't get her presentation. I just heard a couple of sentences, but the one who was presenting before me, she was also talking about take your time when you eat something, really taste it well, sit down, etc., etc. And we totally, most of us are not, in the Western world, are not doing that. And we lost our tastes. So we have to regain it. This is from page, also from Regeneration of Paul Hawken. Big ag, so big agriculture and big food have degraded our land, our soil, our food, our environment, our health. So we're designing a new food system that supports, regenerates life on Earth. This is a nice picture from the book. I read in Regeneration that corn, all the corn in the world, is the crops that we have the most of it. So if you weigh all the crops, corn is the absolute winner. Interesting. Then waste nothing is what Paul is teaching us. One third of the food produced for humans never makes it to our mouth. That's a lot. That's awful. And at the same time, a billion people struggle to get enough food every day. 800 million people are undernourished. So they are really suffering. Their health is really, really suffering. But a billion people in total are struggling every day to get enough food. As we throw away, we just throw away one third of the food produced for humans. It never makes it to our mouth. So there are a lot of solutions. Eat everything, Paul Hawken's teaching us. Very interesting as well. Of the 400,000 species of plants on Earth, only 200 have been widely domesticated. And three species, rice, wheat, and corn, just three species, provide almost 50% of the calories we consume as food and provide as feed to animals. So there's a solution as well. If we want to regenerate the planet, we can start with maybe not the 400,000 species, but much more species than 200. And then, of course, the ecosystems will flourish on that. They will thrive. All kinds of insects and animals and other plants will come back, actually. So 400,000 species of plants on Earth and only 200 have been widely domesticated. And we mainly eat rice, wheat, and corn. Okay. Solution, localization. 34% of total greenhouse gas emissions are caused by the food system. This includes production, transport, processing, packaging, storage, retail consumption, and waste. So now you understand, now you know why the food system is really, really important for our future as a human species. This was the previous book of Paul Hawken. It's called Drawdown. Here's the Dutch title, the most comprehensive plan ever to reverse climate change. I've got it here. It's about 100 climate solutions and we all have to execute them. So it's not about cherry picking. Oh, I'll just do the wind turbines and then we'll stop. No, it's about regenerative agriculture. It's about other kinds of ways to keep our forests. It's about eating a plant-rich diet. It's about solar panels. It's about flexible electricity grids. it's etc. etc. So this is Climate Cleanup has published this one in Dutch a couple of years ago. So as a human species, we actually have got two goals, main goals. Of course, we've got all the sustainability goals, but if you boil them down, I think we have two main goals, and it is stop emissions, stop greenhouse gas emissions, and clean up 1500 gigaton of CO2. This number is, is really a lot. And we found it in scientific research, and practically no one is talking about it. Well, people are talking about negative emissions, which actually don't exist. Are you able to emit something in a negative way? It's a mathematical, theoretical way of looking at emissions. It's just, we have to clean it up. And that's what we're doing at Climate Cleanup. We clean it up using nature, because nature grows on CO2, knows what to do with CO2, as you know. So we have to double nature, and I've got a nice video here. Oh yeah, I'm going to play that for you. I hope it works. This is our double nature video we made at Climate Cleanup to explain what actually is 1500 gigaton, and we're going to explain you that in this video, because it means we have to double nature, we found out, and that's a great, don't you think that's great? It really makes me happy.
We can't hear the audio, Linda. Can you put on the audio?
That you can't hear the audio.
When you're sharing your video in the left down corner, it says share sound. So you have to share it again.
Okay.
So if you stop share now.
Okay, I'll stop share now. Where is my, stop share, yes.
Yeah, and then share screen.
Share screen, yes.
And then a window will pop up, and in the left down corner, it says share sound.
Share screen. Oh, yeah. And that's great, I see it. And now I start sharing again.
Yeah, and then it will play the sound.
Yeah, thank you. No problem. I need a password.
Password?
Yeah. To share your computer audio, please install the Zoom audio device. Oh my God. Oh, it's my own password. Okay, that's no problem. I thought maybe your password. No. Let me see. Maybe it's... I think it should work now. Let me see. Click on. Mm-hmm.
We see your screen now.
So yeah, you see. Click op schermvullende weergave uitschakelen. Click.
Yes.
Okay. Click. Yeah. Now there's something happening. Okay. Presenteren. We're going to try again. Yes.
By now, we all have a clear vision of what impact climate change has on our planet.
It works.
Pushed by the Paris Agreement, the energy transition is here to stay. But even in the best case scenario, we still have an abundance of 1500 gigaton of CO2. It took us humans 150 years to release it, and we need to take it out as soon as possible. 1500 gigaton is difficult to imagine, but what about this? That's the same amount as is already stored by all plants and trees on Earth right now. on land and in the oceans. Oh, and did we forget to tell? That's because nature grows from CO2. So the challenge is clear. To clean up 1500 gigaton, we only have to double nature. True, that sure is a huge challenge, but it can still be done, and often it's even a viable business case. And people like challenges, right? This one is energizing, that's a promise. The fact is, it must be done. And the good news is, it's already happening. Let's double nature.
So, cleaning up 1500 gigaton of CO2 is around the same as doubling nature. And so that's what we as humans have to do, and also in our food system. And it's possible. Okay. How at clean up with people, a community, like our founder Sven Jensen, and with people like Jasmin. She calls herself bio-inspired innovator. She's actually working on all kinds of soil and food solutions at this moment. But a seaweed farmer needs lots and lots of ocean solutions like seaweed. Nikki Spill, she's working on seaweed. We've got Paul, who's working on green minerals like olivine. Olivine is a rock, it's sand, it's rock. It's all around us, not in the Netherlands, but in a lot of places around the world, like Norway, like Turkey. And it's a rock that captures CO2, olivine. Felipe Villela is from Renature Foundation. Google Filipa as well. He's a very interesting guy working on regenerative agroforestry. Maartje, Anita, Freerk, Charlotte, Joost, all also on seaweed. Charlotte working on trees. And that we've got also some supportive people like Freerk. Well, we're 270 people right now at this moment. And our network is much, much bigger, but those people are our members, and they're actually paying Climate Cleanup to be a member. And that gives us the opportunity to work for those people, but independently. So we're not working for any seaweed farmer specifically, but we're working for the sector of regenerating the planet with nature. This is sort of summary. We came up with, okay, we have to clean up this excess of CO2. Where could we do that? For example, in constructions, and we call that construction stored carbon. A construction like this one, made of natural materials like wood, like hemp, like seaweed. There's also sea wood already. If we are going to produce and lots of technical materials to build with, we will store the carbon in it for a very long time. And of course, we are not going to burn anything anymore, so the CO2 will stay in here. And if you want to change your building, you take parts out of it, and then you use clean energy to do so. And that's a way to become regenerative. But we can also store carbon in the soil. We call that soil stored carbon. That's what's mainly our food system, our regenerative food system is going to do. In the soil, there is a lot of, I started with the mycelium, the picture of the mycelium. There's a lot of CO2. But if we've been emitting this CO2 out of the soil when we started with our modern agricultural practices 10,000 years ago, so, you know, plowing and monocultures, etc. And actually, our agricultural practices have emitted more CO2 than burning fossil fuels. Of course, we can store a lot of CO2 again in the oceans, like, for example, in the coasts and mangroves. So we need to do a lot of ecosystem restorations on wetlands and mangroves at shores. But we can also cultivate a lot of seaweed and let the seaweed sink down to the bottom of the ocean floor, and it will be stored away for thousands and thousands of years. So we create carbon sinks. That's what we call that, carbon sinks. And there's a fourth one, we call that rock stored carbon. That's what I was talking about, the olivine. We can store carbon in rocks, and it's gone. It's called chemical weathering, and it changes, the rock changes the chemical the chemics of the CO2. What climate cleanup is also working on is carbon accounting. If we as humans are able to account well for our carbon, and we are better and better in counting for our emissions, but we also have to start accounting for our removal, then the system is going to change. So climate cleanup is working on OnCRA, we call that. OnCRA, it's open natural carbon removal accounting. With climate cleanup, everything is always open. We're open source. We're working for humankind, and we will do what's necessary to regenerate the planet. And therefore we need, there's a nice scheme here. So if those are mainly the natural, the scalable natural climate solutions, like everything that's growing on land, and with the trees, we can make constructions out of it. We can build our homes, etc. All kinds of constructions. The olivine, the minerals, the rocks we have all around the world that remove CO2, and the seaweed. We're going to put the numbers. Oh, sorry. We're going to measure that. That's what we're working on. How can we measure that? So we're working with scientists who know more about it, and we'll come up with a model. And we have to work with trust. So who's going to trust this model? And then we're going to trade the model, and we'll actually get real money, real euros, real dollars into the system, so that entrepreneurs who are actually working on this get an extra income due to their removal of CO2. Because they remove CO2, they will get extra money in. That's what we are working on. We're also working on imagination. If you can't imagine the world that we're going to build, if you can't imagine that you eat something else, you won't do it, because you don't know anything about it and it doesn't look attractive. So that's the reason why Climate Cleanup has bought the documentary 2040, Join the Regeneration, made by this Australian wonderful guy, for his daughter, Velvet, who is 4 years old here. And I think you can watch the documentary on our website. It will cost you €5. But the documentary is also in this festival today. And for young people, you can always send me an email. Young people can watch it for free. And also in every educational situation, we provide the documentary for free. Not for companies with money. That's also a way for us to earn some money. So imagination is very, very, very important. We can't do it without imagination. And so I would like to show you the trailer of Join 2040, Join the Regeneration. So what the documentary maker has done, he has envisioned what the world could look like in 2040 when we have actually executed all the drawdown solutions. What would the world look like? Take a look.
My name is Damon, and this is my daughter, Velvet. Her major concern right now is the elusive art of sleep direction. But soon, she'll have to face a rapidly deteriorating environment.
The ice sheet is now melting faster than the scientists predicted.
I think there's room for a different story, a story that focuses on the solutions to some of these problems. So in 2040, what will the world look like for our daughter if we just embrace the best that already exists?
Instead of having governments that are reacting to disaster, we need governments and businesses that actually take us off in a different direction.
Maybe it's farming, or it can be energy, or it can be housing, or it can be empowering girls.
I'd like to see deforestation being stopped.
Oh, that would be so cool. That'd be awesome.
Just be respectful to Earth.
Imagine Velvet. We've adopted regenerative practices like Fraser's.
Pulling the carbon into the soil and making it healthier.
That's right, yeah.
And we embrace efficient local energy.
Bangladesh has 5 million solar home systems. They have their power in their own hands. This is bringing people together.
But here I am sitting on an aeroplane that is spewing out carbon. You can't help but be a hypocrite because our entire system is built on fossil fuels.
What were you guys thinking?
Well, sometimes we weren't.
Power of innovation, imagination, creativity to sit within all people.
People want to be working on something that they can see is actually helping to regenerate the world.
Everywhere you look, you will see incredible reasons for hope.
You could feed 10 billion people with the protein from marine permaculture alone.
Wow. Not only are there so many people who want to take part in telling a new story, we have everything we need right now to make it happen. What's your 2040?
I just want the future to be good.
Yeah, it always makes me so happy to watch this trailer. Gives me goosebumps all every time again. So thanks to Damon Gameau, the guy, the father in this movie, we are able to show the world and tell what's possible. It's all about what's possible. Okay, next. Yeah, power to the burgers. Yeah, I'm very much of power to the people. So this is the burger joke I made. For Dutch people, take a look at this website, www.socialtippingpointcoalitie.nl. This is a whole bunch of organizations around the Netherlands working on social tipping point, social tipping points. Scientists have pointed out social tipping points like divestments in fossil fuels, like asking for our pension funds to stop investing in fossil fuels. Maybe you've seen the Trouw Top 100 in the Netherlands, this newspaper of sustainable people. All the activist people are rewarded for their social tipping point actions because it's about us. If we want to change, the change is going to happen. And of course, we have to influence the system, like climate cleanup, for example, is doing so perfectly with this UNCRA system. We're changing the where the money goes to. If the money goes to the right place, the world will change faster. You can also subscribe at socialtippingpointcoalitie.nl to a manifesto. So please do. And you'll help our lots and lots of friends. Well, I'm almost at the end. Of course, or not of course, but I've started in my own neighborhood, and that's Amsterdam Eiburg. And this is my local organization, Natuurlijk Eiburg, natuurlijkeiburg.nl. And those are my friends, local friends. And we come together now and then, and we work on greening the streets, solar panels on school roofs, repair cafe, cleaning up the neighborhood from plastic waste, things like that. And a couple of years ago, we were only a small group, but we're growing and growing, and more people are fed up with the way the world looks and all the pollution. And yeah, and so it's really up to us who know, who understand, who have power and the energy to lead our neighborhoods, our communities, to help our communities in the right direction and start doing that as soon as you can. Join the regeneration. We are the mycelium as people as well. And yeah, you can email me at linda@climatecleanup.org for any questions. If you would like to know more about drawdown or regeneration, the book Regeneration of Paul Hawken, or about 2040, the movie 2040, Join the Regeneration. Reach out and yeah, I hope to see you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Linda, for the insightful time and for all of the resources you shared with us. That was really helpful. Do you have any social media we can reach you on? That's for the organization.
Yeah, we're on all social media, LinkedIn. Okay. Yeah, LinkedIn and Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. You can find us anywhere, okay. Everywhere and anywhere.
Okay, we'll do that. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Yes.
And have a good day.
Yes.